The Lord Danforth line, again, is running, except for a short section between Victoria Park and Morden. There is no service on the Shepherd line, and we are running a bus shuttle vice to Shepherd. There is no service on the SRT, Scarborough Rapid Transit, and again, we're running a bus shuttle vice that service. Bus services generally are running, albeit we've had to thin some of the routes out in order to provide the emergency bus shuttles. The biggest challenge we have, and this is ongoing, is with the streetcar lines, where the copper wire that provides the power has such thick ice on it that even though last night we deployed what are called cutters and sliders, they're devices that you fit to the poles, the trolley poles of the streetcars, they just could not get through the ice, it's that thick. So our strategy has been to focus particularly, provide particular focus on keeping the subway going and on keeping an alternative bus service going. And as and when the weather warms up and we can get the ice broken off the streetcar wires, then we will do that. My latest information is the bus shuttles are running well. We do say to customers, please be careful getting on and off vehicles, because obviously you've got to be careful when you step down onto the sidewalk, and I do be careful. I'd like to acknowledge the fantastic work of my staff out there. It's difficult conditions. The staff particularly trying to get the overhead clear. It's pretty horrendous what they're doing, but we've got all hands to the pump. We've fired up our transit control centre. It has additional staff in it to make sure that we are getting these services back up and running as quickly as possible.
How much are you concerned are the winds of the streetcar cable with the ice on?
That will be a challenge for us. I mean, if the temperature warms up, then the ice will start to melt on the copper wire, and at which point we can get streetcars, what are called storm cars, running up and down the streetcar tracks to then try to keep them clear, but obviously wind will be a challenge for us. Increasingly, as the afternoon wears on, our focus will turn to trying to make sure we have a good start-up tomorrow when obviously people are back at work. If we can keep the buses going and keep the subway going, and at the moment that is working, then we'll be fine. But one thing we're also keeping a very close eye on is making sure we get fuel deliveries to our bus garages to make sure that we can fuel the buses, but also keep the power on at the bus garages so that the fuel pumps will work. Well, I mean, they're designed to cope with wind, but obviously the fact that they've got ice sort of makes them more vulnerable. It's same as what our colleagues were saying, Anthony in particular, if a wire were to come down, you should treat it as light, you should not go anywhere near it.
For the commute tomorrow, what do you anticipate the time will be for people going to work?
Well, my best advice is that customers should keep an eye on our website, www.ttc.ca. We also have our e-alert service up and running. We're pumping out information on the subway and on the surface networks. So do keep an eye on the website. Well, our aim is to get everything up and running tomorrow morning. I think the biggest challenge will still be the streetcar network.
Do you think the streetcar network will be up tomorrow then?
At the moment, it's hard to say. If the weather gets worse and the melt doesn't happen on the copper wire, then I think there's a real chance that the streetcars won't be up and running. If that does happen, then we will continue to run a bus service via the streetcars. And what I should say is there will be longer waits than usual, because in order to provide shuttles for all of the streetcars, we have to take buses off other routes.